We do not own the rights to this music, but we appreciate Michael Franti for creating a better world for us. And I also teach, so I am trying to bring, I don't have four-wall studio, a yoga studio, so I take my yoga into different places. So I offer free class here on Monday nights at 6:30. And then I also teach, if you guys are ever interested, out at Edwards Greenhouse. So in the spring and the summer, I'm out in the garden, in the Legacy Garden, and then in the fall and the winter time, they create a space inside. So I'm inside and it's fantastic. There's citrus trees blooming and all of the flowers and all of that scent is in there. It's a magical, magical place. So if you guys ever want to join me there, this summer I'm also going to be doing for a month period, if you guys are familiar with Red Chair Lavender. It's a farm out in Eagle. And if you've been to the Red Chair Lavender Festival, it's pretty busy, so we can't really do yoga while it's going on. But the 4 weeks leading up to it, we're going to do sunset yoga, probably on a Friday night, out in the center of the lavender field. So it's going to be, if you guys have ever been out there, it's awesome. Yeah, I love those guys. And then other little things here and there. So if you guys want to follow me on Instagram, it's Jason Allen Carr, YouTube, Jason Allen Carr, and Facebook, Jason Allen Carr. And then my yoga studio is called YogaPop. And I call it YogaPop because I use pop culture references to get people into places as opposed to using Sanskrit because a lot of people don't understand. So for one example, and you can use this visualization during our meditation of lighting up the dance floor. If you guys have seen, I can't believe I have to even say that like that. If you guys have seen Michael Jackson's Billie Jean video, when he steps onto the square, it lights up below him. So when we walk on this planet, we're leaving our energetic footprint behind. We're also exchanging electrons between the earth and our physical bodies. That decreases inflammation within our body. So use that visualization. So when we're going through a practice and you step into your warrior one, light up your mat. When we're doing the meditation at the end, light up the floor behind, around you and then breathe that energy into the body. Also in the video example I use it with my kids, they don't even call it Michael Jackson video, they call it the white light video, which I love. In the video, he flips a quarter to the homeless man and his cup lights up. He showed an act of kindness. He's sharing his energy and then all of a sudden the homeless man goes from wearing tattered clothing into a white tuxedo. So I kind of like use that to get people visually into their space and their yoga. So, yay. You guys ready? Let's start. Let's all start in a tabletop position. It's not working. Do, 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 do.
Keep it real, y'all. Keep it real.
You ready? Let's all start in tabletop position. Feel the love. This music has a lot of really good energy in it, so just take the opportunity to feel and be present. Stay out of the thoughts of the mind. In our tabletop, let's just get warmed up a little bit. Tap the top of the feet to the mat here. And then curl those toes. And then we're going to paint the mat with our feet. So press the toes away and then roll them back like you're painting your mat. Feel that white light igniting in this space. Take the heels out to the side and get the inside of those pinky toes. Bring the heels together and get the inside of those big toes. Come to center. Let's just curl the toes and set ourselves back here. Maybe reach around and spread the toes a little bit wider. Gently press into the knees, bringing them forward, and let's find a little bit of breath. Let's inhale, bring the hands up. Take deep breath in, exhale, hands down to the sky. Inhale, hands up, feel that C curve in your lower back. Exhale, hands back down. One more time, inhale, hands up. Exhale, hands down to the side. Lean forward, curl your toes, and then press yourself back. Give those ankles a stretch by bringing those knees up off the mat. Maybe find a little bit of balance here. And then then come to straight inhale, bring the hands up. Exhale, hands down. This time, inhale, bring the hands up. On an exhale, kick the left hand to the right knee. Roll your right shoulder, looking over your right shoulder. Lengthen the spine. Inhale, back up to center. Exhale, right hand to the left knee. Roll that left shoulder. Inhale, come up. Exhale, hands down to the side. Let's slide those hands forward here. Let's warm up the body by taking, creating figure eights with the body. So we're going to start by taking that left hip over that left heel. We're going to circle around to the right heel, cross the body to the left wrist, and then the right wrist. Take it back to that left heel, right heel, left wrist, right wrist, and back. And just take it with your own speed. Come to center. Let's take it in the opposite direction. You're going to take that left hip over that left heel, circling around to the right, crossing the body to the left wrist, and then the right wrist. Back to that left heel, right heel, left wrist, and back. Nice deep breaths. Allow yourself to really take advantage of the music in this space. And then come to center. Let's take that right leg back and just reach that right toe. Drop your hip just slightly. Let's bring the right leg down. Take the left leg back. Reach out through that left big toe. And then bring the left leg in with those shoulders directly over those wrists. Bring the eyes and the elbows forward, knees underneath the hips, tops of the feet pressed into the mat. Drop your belly on an inhale and look up. Take the hips side to side. Come to center. We're going to bring the chin to the chest on the exhalation. Press firmly through the palms of the hands. Go deep into those shoulders and then rock back and forth here, going even deeper into those muscles across the shoulder blades. Come to center. Drop the belly. Inhale, look up. Exhale in. Take it back and forth here with your own movement. And then come back to center. Let's take the right leg back once again. Press into that right palm. Take your left bicep to your left ear. We're reaching out through that left middle finger and that right big toe. Drop your right hip, belly button in tight. Take a deep breath in and reach. Exhale, crunch it in, knee to nose. Inhale, reach. Exhale, crunch. Inhale, reach. Exhale, crunch. Inhale, reach and pause. Bend your right knee. Take your left hand around to grab onto that ankle notch. Press into your right palm and then kick. Look up. Maybe squeeze your right glute. And then gently release. Let's take it to the other side. Left leg goes back, dropping that left hip. That foot is parallel to the floor. Right bicep to the right ear as you reach out to that right middle finger, left big toe. Take a deep breath in and reach. Exhale, crunch. Inhale, reach. Exhale, crunch. Inhale, reach. Exhale, crunch. Inhale, reach and pause. Bend your left knee. Take the right hand around to grab. Kick up. Look up. Squeeze your left glute if that feels good. Come straight on that left arm. Gently release. Let's walk the hands slightly forward. Actually, let's give the wrists a break for a second. Come down onto the forearms. Curl the toes. Let's take a dolphin pose. Take the hips towards the sky and then walk the feet towards the face. Press the heels towards the floor as you press away from those forearms. The belly button comes closer to those sides. The head and neck are relaxed as you look back between the legs. And then bring the head to look in between your forearms here. Melt your heart to the floor. Feel a little curve, like a little ditch in where the spine is. And then look back between the legs. Come down to the knees, toes together, press back to a child pose. Walk the hands over to the left. Press away from the palms to send the hips toward the heels. Come back to center and take those hands all the way over to the right, pressing away from the palms, sending the hip towards the heel here. And then come back to center. Let's find a downward facing dog. pedal your dog back and forth here, one beat at a time.
Check it out. Here comes the mic controller. I think I want
to
take
them
this
to center, feet are hips apart.
Like
press away from the palms to the hands. Let's bend both knees, 6 to 12 inches above the mat. Press away from the palms, bring the belly button to touch those thighs. Head comes deep in between those shoulder blades. Feel that lengthening of the spine. Take the hips high to the sky, high up off of those heels. Press away from the palms, lower the heels all the way to the floor. Bring the belly button closer, head goes deep, feel your downward facing dog. Take the right leg high, point to the sky. Feel that energy line from that right middle finger up to that right big toe. Let's stick that leg in a circle three times to the right. Pause, take it three times in the opposite direction. Bring the right leg down. Take the left leg high, point it to the sky. Three circles to the left. Pause, three circles to the right. Bring the left leg down. Take the right leg high, point it to the sky. Bend the knees, stack the hip. Look underneath your left arm, put it your right big toe. Take the right knee a little bit higher. Bring the right leg down. Take the left leg high. Bend the knees, stack the hip. Look underneath your right arm, put it your left big toe. Maybe take your right heel towards the floor. Left leg down. Right leg high. Point it to the sky. Bring it all the way through to the front and between those hands. You're going to follow with that left foot. Inhale up into your flat back. Hands are just above or below the knees. The crown of the forehead is forward. So we're making an L shape with our body. Bring the shoulder blades together to create that flat back. And then exhale forward, fold, relax. Palms face up next to the feet. Now, relax the hips. Release the hips. And then we want to melt the muscles in the lower back. And then melt and relax the muscles in the mid-back. Relax and melt the muscles in the upper back and the shoulders. Roll those shoulders forward, allowing yourself to go deeper. So the upper body is relaxed from the waist to the shoulders. Lift the hips to the sky on an inhale. Exhale, melt. Inhale, lift. Exhale, melt. Palms face down next to those feet. Bend the knees deeply. Inhale, rise. Root rise all the way up. Nice deep breath in. Take a slight back bend. Exhale, hinge all the way down. Draw the hands up the legs. Flat back. Hands to the mat. Right foot back. Left foot back. Find a plank. Let's build it. So when we move into our plank, our feet are hip width apart. Come up over those wrists. Gently press into the fingertips. Create a little space under the fingers. So if you had a pen or a pencil, you can slide it underneath. As you come up over those wrists, press the heels away so you feel the hamstrings coming out the back of the leg. The thighs are in tight. For the modification of our flow, we're going to drop down to our knees. Today, we're going to bring the toes together. Press back into a child's pose. Then draw the hands towards the body on an inhale, coming all the way up. Nice deep breath in. And then we'll exhale, bring the hands forward. Curl the toes downward facing dog. Let's do this together. Inhale into plank. Down to the knees. Toes together. Press back. Child's pose. Inhale, come all the way up. Exhale, slide the body forward, curl the toes, downward facing dog. Let's take it to the other side. Left leg high, bend the knees, stack the hip all the way through to the front. Follow it with the right foot. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. This time, melt those muscles in the lower back into the mid back, into the upper back. Roll the shoulders forward. The upper body presses up against the thighs. Lift the hips. And then lean forward into the toes and the balls of the feet. Firmly press the heels in. Lift the hips. Relax the upper body forward. And then let's take the palms face up underneath the balls of the feet. Head and neck are relaxed. Lengthen. Bend the knees deeply. Release the palms face down. Inhale. Root rise. Nice deep breath in. All the way up. Take a slight back bend. Exhale, hinge all the way down. Draw the hands up the legs. Inhale, exhale, hands to the mat. Left foot back, right foot back. Find and build your plank. Down to the knees, child's pose. Inhale, come up. Exhale, slide those hands forward. Curl the toes, downward facing dog. Let's foot together with the breath. Right leg high. Bend the knees. Stack the head. Follow it into the front. Follow it with the left foot. Feet together. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Bend the knees. Inhale, rise. Take deep breath in. Slide back in. Exhale, hinge. Inhale, flat back. Hands to the mat. Right foot back. Left foot back. Find your plank. Down to those knees. Child's pose. Inhale, up. Exhale, downward facing dog. Left leg high. Bend the knees, stack the hip all the way through to the front. Follow with the right foot, feet together. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Bend the knees, inhale, rise. Feel the energy, slight back bend. Exhale, hinge. Inhale, flat back. Hands to the mat. Left foot back, right foot back. Find your plank and take it through that flow. Exhaling back into your child's pose. Inhaling up. Exhale, sliding the hands forward. Downward facing dog. Take the right leg high. Bend the knees. Stack the hip all the way through to the front. Drop your left knee. Inhale, rise. Exhale, hinge. Hover above that right knee. Reach out to those fingertips. Inhale, down and up. Exhale, back. Inhale, down and up. Exhale, back. Curl that back toe. Press up. Runner's lunge. Hands are still back. Feel the strength in the body. Engage the core. Inhale, hands down and up. Runner's lunge. Let's take the right hand forward. Left hand back. Come back up to center. Left hand forward. Right hand back. Swing the right hand down and up. Feel the muscles in the right leg and that right glute as you kick off your back foot, bringing it to the front, feet together. Inhale, keep the pinkies in, thumbs out, hands up. Exhale, sit down into your chair pose. Ears are close to the biceps, squeeze the thighs together. Engage the core. Let's bring the hands to heart center. Come up high off of those heels and pause. You're squeezing the thighs together. You're engaging the core. You're feeling your balance. Crown of the forehead forward. Breathe. Hold. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, drop the heels. Inhale, rise. Exhale, hinge. Inhale, draw the hands up, the legs flat back. Hands to the mat, right foot back, left foot back. Build your plank. This time, we're going to build up our body strength by bending those. You can drop down to those knees if you'd like. To build up our body strength, you're going to bend those elbows, slide them down the rib cage, moving into a chaturanga. Flip over those toes, upward facing dog. The top of the body is off of the mat except for the tops of the feet. You can stay right here. Squeeze the glutes. Maybe look up and rest the head in between the shoulder blades. Curl the toes. Downward facing dog. Take the left leg high. Bend the knees. Stack the head all the way through to the front. Drop that right knee. Inhale, rise. Exhale, wings of a bird. Inhale, down and up. Exhale, wings of a bird. Inhale, down and up. Curl that back toe. Press up. Runner's lunge. Right hand forward, left hand back. Swing the left hand down and up. Take it to the other side. Left hand forward, right hand back. Right hand comes down. Feel the muscles in that left leg and that left glute. Right foot comes to the left. Feet together. Let's bring the hands to heart center. Take the hands back. Wings of a bird. Sit into your chair. Lift the chest. Squeeze the thighs together. Engage the core. Come up high. Off of the heels and pause. Breathe. Hands back to heart center. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, drop it. Inhale, rise. Exhale, hinge. Inhale, flat back. Hands to the mat. Left foot back. Right foot back. Find your plate. Take it through one of those flows. Let's exhale down. Inhale, up. Exhale. Downward facing dog. Let's take the right leg high. Bend the knees. Stack the hip. Bring it all the way through to the front. Let's drop that back foot in a 15 or 45 degree angle. Press into your right foot. Inhale, rise. Engage the core. Let's find a warrior one. Let's make adjustments. Hands to the hips. You want your right hip to go back, your left hip to go forward. Press into the back of that left foot. Feel your left inner thigh coming into the core, like you're squeezing the legs together, and lean into your right knee. So we're shrinking from the waist down, and we're lifting from the waist up, hands up over the head, belly button in tight. Let's find some breath. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, wings of a bird. Inhale, down and up. Exhale, wings of a bird. Inhale, down and up. Let's pause. Straighten your right leg. Come up off of that heel to safely open up into our warrior two. Left foot goes out to the side. Roll those shoulders back. Lean into your right knee. Let's make adjustments. You tuck the pelvic bone forward. Roll the shoulders back. Squeeze the muscle to the bones as you reach out to the right and left middle finger. Squeeze the inner thighs as you press out to the outside of that back foot. Look over your line of energy out through that right middle finger. Squeeze the glutes. Squeeze the inner thighs. Engage the core. Bring the muscle to the bone around the rib cage. Again, roll the shoulders back. Squeeze the muscles to the bone, reaching out through those fingers. Take a deep breath in. Flip your right palm. Hinge forward. Reverse warrior. Lean into your right knee. Feel that energy line. Taking the energy out through that right middle finger. Slowly come back. Warrior two. Straighten your right leg. Hinge at the waist. Triangle pose. Right hand down. Left hand high. You're pulling the body towards the ceiling. Chin is in alignment with your shoulder. There's no weight in that bottom hand. Engage the core. Slowly come back up. Find your warrior two. Wiggle your hands to the mat. Take the right foot back. Your right hand finds the center of the mat as you take your left ankle on top of the right foot. Side twist. Left hand high. Shoulders are stacked. Flex your left foot. Bring it up in alignment with the spine. If you've got this, point your left toe. Left hand goes over the head, creating a rainbow shape with the body. Feel it. Come back to center. Find your plank. And when you're ready, exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale. Downward facing dog. Let's take it to that other side. Left leg hop. Bend the knee, stack the hip all the way through to the front. Plant that back foot. 15 or 45 degree angle. Inhale, rise. Warrior one. Make adjustments. Hands to the hip. Right hip forward, left hip back. Belly button's in tight. Feel that right inner thigh coming into the core again, like you're squeezing the legs together. Lean into your left knee. You want to make sure that the left knee is in alignment with the foot going forward. It's not going to the right, it's not going to the left. The knees over the ankle. Press the back side of that back foot. Irish. Hands up over the head. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, shrink. Feel it. This is your warrior one. Straighten your left leg. Open up, warrior two. Lean into that left knee. Tuck the pelvic bone forward. Press to the outside of that back foot. Roll the shoulders. Squeeze the muscle to the bone. If you reach out to the left and right middle finger, maybe take that left knee just slightly over to the left. Squeeze the inner thigh. Squeeze your glutes. Move your left palm on an inhale. Reach forward. Reverse warrior. Feel that energy line. Lean into your left knee. No weight in that back hand. Slowly come back. Warrior two. Straighten your left leg. Lean just the waist. Left hand down. Right hand high. Pull the body up towards the ceiling like somebody's holding you over a cliff. Chin in alignment with your shoulder. No weight in that bottom hand. Slowly come back up. Find your warrior two. Windmill your hands to the mat. Left hand finds the center as you take the left leg back. Line up those shoulders for your side plank. Right ankle on top of left. Flex your right foot. Bring it up in alignment with the spine or stay right there. If you want to go further, point your right toe. Take it over the head, creating that rainbow shape. Breathe. Beautiful. Come back to center. Find your plank. You know what? Before, let's just kind of find a downward dog. Let's take the hips over to the right. Come back to center. Take the hips over to the left. Come back to center. Find your plank. And then exhale through the flow down. Inhale up. Exhale. Downward facing dog. Let's put it all together with the breath. Inhale. Right leg high. Bend the knee, stack the hip. We're going to fall to the outside of the left foot. Drop your right foot close to the body as you flip your dog. Right hand goes over ahead. Lift those hips. slowly come back to center. I'm a Libra. We gotta do it on both sides. Take the left leg high, bend the knee, stack the hip. Fall to the outside of that right foot. Left foot rocks close to the body. Left hand overhead. Slowly come back to center. Right leg high. Bend the knee, stack the hip all the way through to the front. Drop that back foot. Inhale, rise, warrior one. Open up, warrior two. Get that right palm in, forward, reverse warriors. Windmill your hands to the mat. Right foot back, find your plank and flow. Exhale down, inhale up, exhale. Downward facing dog. Left leg high, bend the knee, stack the hip, flip that jaw. One more time. To the outside of that right foot, drop the left, and up overhead. Come back to center. Right leg high, bend the knee, stack the hip, fall to the outside of that left foot, flipping your dog once again. Shoulders are stacked. Lift the hip, back to center. Left leg high. Bend the knees, stack the hips all the way through to the front. Plant that back foot, inhale, rise. Warrior one, make those adjustments. Open up, warrior two. Lift that left palm, inhale, reverse. Windmill the hands to the mat. Left foot goes back. Find your plank and flow. Exhale down, inhale up, exhale. Downward facing dog. Come down to your knees, toes together. Let's find a child's pose. Three. Love the belly. So rest in between the thighs. If you want to take a sip of water, please do.
My mama told me, don't lose you. Cause the best luck I had was you. And I know one thing.
Just take a couple breaths. Feels good. Let's do it one more time and then we'll find some standing poses. Let's all meet in a downward facing dog. Right leg high, take a deep breath in. On the exhale, right foot comes to the front. Plant that back foot, inhale, rise. Warrior one. Make those adjustments, open up. Warrior two. Lift that right palm, reverse forward. Windmill the hands to the mat. Right foot back. Find your plank and flow. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale, downward facing dog. Left leg high. All the way through to the front. Plant that back foot. Inhale, rise. Warrior one. Open up. Warrior two. Flip that left palm. Reverse. Windmill the hands to the mat. Left foot back. Find your plank and flow. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale, downward facing dog. Let's walk the hands towards the feet. Slowly rise one vertebra at a time. Hey. Does everybody feel good? Good. Let's find some balance. Feet, hip width apart. Bring the hands out in front of us. Maybe roll the shoulders back just slightly. Sit down into your chair. Let's lift the toes. Replant the toes, sit a little deeper. Take the legs out, bring them back in. Feel the glutes, feel the muscles in the legs. Just pause. Let's lift the chest up a little bit higher. Sit a little deeper. Lift the toes. Replant the toes, feel the bottoms of the feet on the floor. Then slowly rise as you feel the muscles of the legs. This is where we get the benefit. Feel those muscles, awareness. Come up high off of those heels. Find a spot to focus on. Sometimes it's a little hard with all the lights going on. It's like we're sliding down a wall as you slowly lower. We want to keep the heels up as high as we can. Lift the knees a little higher. Maybe find a spot. Pause. Lift the heels higher. Hold. Engage the core. Slide back up that wall for the muscles in the legs. Release one more. I like to bring my feet slightly in. The palms are still out front. Lift the heels about 1 or 2 inches. Squeeze the thighs together. Slide back down that wall. Engage the core. Squeeze the thighs. Slowly rise. Release. Shake it up. We are alive. Thank God. Let's find some balance.
the time bounce correctly. Left hand, left knee. Bounce on that one leg. And then come to stillness. Left knee, left armpit. Roll those shoulders back, engage the core. This is good. Roll the ankle to the left and to the right. Engage the core. Find your spot in front of you to focus on. Beautiful. Let's release. Check it out. Take it to the other side. My back. Right hand, right knee. Left hand, right ankle. Come to stillness. Right knee turns deep, engage the core, shoulders back, maybe roll that ankle to the left and to the right. Awesome, release it, shake it off. Yes. Okay, find some more bounce. Let's start mount pose. Feet together, shoulders back, palms forward, close the eyes. Let's deep breath in, exhale. Inhale through the nose. Exhale at the mouth. Inhale, hands up over the head. Exhale, hands down to the side. Inhale, hands up. Bring the palms together, cross the thumbs. Watch the biceps of the ears, take the hips side to side. Come to stillness, inhale, reach up. Take it over to your left, opposite of me. Right shoulder goes back, left shoulder slightly forward. You're pressing out through that right hip. Belly button's in tight. Maybe bring your chin in alignment with your shoulder. Release your left hand to your left thigh. Press into that left thigh, go deeper. Slowly come back up, taking your time. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, take it to the other side. Left shoulder slightly back, right shoulder slightly forward. Press out through that left hip. Maybe bring the chin in alignment with the shoulder. Belly button's in tight. Release your right hand to your right thigh. Press into your right thigh, go deeper. Left hand goes up over the head. Feel that deep stretch along the left hand side. Release, come back up to center. Palms together, cross those thumbs. Hip side to side, belly button in tight, look up at your wrist. On an inhale, we're going to reach up. And on an exhale, we're going to take the hips forward as we draw a line across the sky, going into our back bend. It doesn't matter how far back you go. Slowly come up, hinge the waist all the way down. Be mindful of the spine. Hands touch the mat. Heel, toe, the feet hip-width apart. Relax the head and neck as you look back between the legs. Once again, relax the muscles in the lower back, into the mid back, into the upper back. Roll those shoulders forward, and then let's walk the hands over to the left. Lift the right hip. Come back to center, take the hands over to the right. Lift the left hip. Come back to center, ragdoll. Grab opposite elbows, head and neck are relaxed as you look back between the legs. Bring the hands to the mat. Take the toes out, heels in, sit down into a yogi squat. Hands to heart center. Take the elbows and press those knees back. Lengthen the spine, sitting up straight. Let's come up high off of those heels. Feel a little bit of balance here. Lower the heels. Let's take the hands shoulder length apart, fingers spread wide or together, whatever feels best to you. And then we're going to move into a crow pose. If you want to watch me first, please feel free. We'll do it twice. So for me, everybody's arm length is different. So my elbow's right in the crack of my, where my knee is. Hands are shoulder length apart. As you come forward, you're going to drop the hands shoulder length here. And then when you're ready, don't look back between the legs because you'll fall forward. You want to keep looking forward as you do come up off those heels. Bring the big toes together for your crow pose. Slowly come back into your yogi squat. And pause. Dig it one more time. And shoulder length apart. Slowly come down. Crown of the forehead goes forward. Bring those big toes together. Take that crow pose. Slowly come back. hands to heart center. Let's bring the hands to the outside. Bring the feet in and slowly rise. Take your goddess pose. Come to the side of your mat. Heels in, toes out. Either 3 feet, 4 feet, whatever feels good. Heels are in, toes are out. Let's cactus the arms here. Roll those shoulders back. Tuck the pelvic bone forward as you slowly sit down into your goddess pose. Maybe rock side to side if that feels good. Sit a little bit deeper. Let's lift the toes and the balls of the feet and then replant them real quick. Press into the toes, feel the ball of the foot, the heel, sit a little deeper. Lift the right heel up. Lower the right heel, lift the left heel. Lower the left heel. Pause, lift both heels and pause, hold. Nice balance. Drop the heels, inhale, come up into a star. Hands go out, heels go out. Hinge at the waist slowly and mindfully, taking the hands to the outsides of the feet. Crown of the forehead goes towards the floor. Look back between the legs. Lean slightly forward into the toes and the balls of the feet. Looking back between the legs, set the hips back. Try to bring the head in between the legs. Maybe straighten the legs a little bit more. Bring the palms face down in front of you. Press through the palms here. Inhale, right hand high, side twist. Take that right hand around. Roll your right shoulder. Come back to center. Right hand comes down. Left hand goes high. Left hand goes around for a wrap. Roll that left shoulder. Left hand comes down. Lean into your, bend your left knee. Leaning over to the left. Come up on your right heel. Feel the stretch. Walk the hands over to the right. Take it back and forth here. Of sunshine coming down. Come back to center. Press the palms into the mat. Take the hands out to the side. Nice strong core. Slowly rise all the way back up. Heels in, toes out. Cactus the hands. Sit back down into your goddess pose. Maybe rock side to side. Let's bring the hands to the knees. Take your left shoulder forward. Press the left knee away. Come back to center. Take the right shoulder forward. Press it to that right knee. Come back to center. Lift the left heel. Lower the left heel. Lift the right heel. Lower the right heel. Inhale. Come all the way up into your star. Take the heels out. Change the waist all the way down. Hands on the outside for those legs. Put that between the legs. Hands come back to center. Press through those hands. This time, bring the hands out to the side as you slowly rise, engage the core. When we come up, bring the heels in, toes out. Let's bring the hands back behind us. Clasp the hands together. Let's just pull the hands down and then pull them away from the body. Look up. Bring the head back to center. Take that right shoulder forward. Press the leg with the palms of the hands. Come back to center. Look over to the right. Pull the hands away. Come back to center. Heel, toe, the feet together. Let's find mountain pose. Roll the shoulders back. Palms face up next to the body. Just relax here. Close the eyes. Find a little bit of balance. Shake it off. We're going to start with that right leg. We're going to start with a little tiny, itty-bitty baby tree. We're going to take that left leg and find balance. Take your right foot either up on the toe or on the ball of the foot right here. You want your right knee parallel with the body. As you lengthen the body on the left-hand side, lift the chest, engage the core. Bring your hands to heart center. When you have find a spot in front of you to focus on, when you feel like you've got your balance, in order to hold the pose, you need to keep the core engaged and focus on the breath. And then with your focus spot in front of you, slowly close the eyes around your focus spot. Stay focused with the breath and the engagement of the core to help hold you here. Slowly open the eyes. Draw that right foot to the inside of that left calf. That knee's still in alignment. with the body, lengthen the body on the left hand side, maybe squeeze the left glute. When you have your balance, engage the core, stay focused with the breath, and close your eyes here around your focal spot. If you fall out, get back in, close the eyes. And then release, shake it off. It's a lot of work on that leg. Let's find balance in that right leg. Little baby tree. Up on the toes or on the ball of the foot, whatever you, same variation you took on that opposite side. Knees in alignment with the body, belly button tight. Lengthen the spine, hands to heart center. Engage the core. The engagement of the core, your focal spot in the breath that holds you here. Once you feel like you have it, slowly close the eyes. Come up, open the eyes. Take that left foot on the inside of that right thigh. Maybe lift the right toes and plant them, engage the core. And then when you're ready, slowly close your eyes.
Release. Shake it off.
Giving you the first verse.
Happy
you
birthday.
Might never get a second verse. This ain't rehearsal, so you can't put it in reverse. So just believe.
All right. Let's do, standing forward. I love this pose. So let's find balance in the left leg. Right elbow, right hip. You're going to drop your hand down so your palms facing away as you grab the inside of your right foot, not the outside, the inside. Just helps roll the right shoulder back, bring the left hand to that right shoulder, roll it back. So I find that it helps to keep that right toe pointed to the sky. You're squeezing the thighs together, you're balanced on that left leg, nice and straight. Take the left hand high. On a deep breath in, we're going to reach up. On an exhale, start to kick into your right hand, drawing the body forward. It's the kick that draws the body forward. Find a sight line over your left middle finger. You kick harder, engage the core. If you feel like you're going to fall out, that's what holds you in the pose. Breathe. Slowly come out by kicking. And release. Take it to the other side. Walk it off. This is our last standing pose. We come down to the mat. Find balance in that right leg. Left elbow, left hip. Drop that hand to the inside of the foot, not the outside. Right hand finds the left shoulder. Roll it back. Right hand high. Squeeze the thighs together. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, kick into your left foot. Keep that left toe pointed to the sky. That helps with the balance. Find a sight line over your right middle finger. Engage the core. Release when you're ready. Yay, everybody come down onto your mat. Come onto your back. Bring the knees into the chest. Give yourself a hug. Little circles to the left and the right. Take a sip of water here if you need it. And then let's just take the legs off to straight. Take the palms face up next to the body. Let's just relax here. Maybe wiggle around. And then just come to stillness. Let's take three deep breaths together. Inhaling through the nose. Exhaling out the mouth. Inhale through the nose. Exhale out the mouth. Inhale through the nose. Exhale out the mouth. Bring the heels close to the glutes. Let's get a little bit of ab work in. Let's first take another little break by bringing the feet up off the mat. Bring the big toes together and then take the hands to grab the outside of those knees. And then just kind of hover here. Maybe release the toe grip. Just kind of so your hands are holding your knees here. Bring the toes together, hands on those knees. Let's make a circular motion in here. Pause and take it in the opposite direction.
Take the legs up to the sky. Let's flex the toes towards the face. Bring your hands on the back of the legs, wherever feels comfortable for you. I like the knees. And let's just flex the toes towards the face. Reach out to those heels. Point the toes. Go back and forth a couple of times here. And then come to stillness. Let's flex the toes towards the face. Bring the hands back behind the head or the neck. So you want to look up at the ceiling. So our upper body again is relaxed, like we're lying in a hammock, but our glutes, our abs are engaged. With those float toes flexed, bend your left knee deeply. Take that right leg into a hover position, or just where the back starts to lift up off of the mat. Keep the toes flexed and take it back to the other side. Bend the right knee. Take that left leg out, lower it into a hover position, and just take it back and forth here at your own speed, either going fast or going slow. I find if you go slow, you can feel me a little bit more in awareness, in the feel of the body. Feel how the glutes engage, the abs engage, the thighs, the inner thighs, the calves. We're reaching out through those heels, keeping those toes flexed. Now let's point the toes and continue with that same movement. Head and neck are relaxed, you're looking up at the ceiling. Flex the toes, add lifting the lower back up off the mat like you're shooting up into a shoulder step. Point the toes, stay with that same movement. Bring the knees into the chest, give yourself a hug. Feel all the work you've done on those abs. Hands back behind the shoulders. We're going to take our back behind the neck for the head. Take the legs to the sky. So from here, we're going to bend the knees in. Lift the lower back up off the mat. Take the legs out to the straight. Shoot them back up. Come down. Bring the knees in. Take the legs out and up. Come down. Bring the knees in. Legs out and up. Flex those feet. Knees come into the chest, little circles to the left and the right. Let's roll the body all the way up. Come around onto your belly. Right ear comes to the mat, palms face up next to the body. Rock the hips side to side. It feels good. We're going to do reverse windshield wipers, bend those knees, and then just take the feet side to side. Come to center, let the legs go out to stretch, relax. Take a couple breaths. Bring the hands underneath those shoulders. Bring the chin to the mat. We're going to do a little bit of rolling the body here. So the chin's on the mat. Just lift the head just slightly. We're moving into baby cobra. Let's roll the right shoulder back, left shoulder back. Those elbows are in nice and tight. Feel that opening on the chest. You're going to press into the tops of the feet, bringing the knees up off the mat. Squeeze the glutes, zipping the legs up tight. And then let's look up for our baby cobra. Elbows come in tighter. Feel that resistance in the lower back as you reach out through those big toes. And then bring the chin towards the chest, lengthening the spine here. Elbows come in a little tighter. Reach out through those big toes. Relax the legs. Press into the palms. King Cobra, come all the way up. Look up. Bend your left elbow. Come back to center. Bend your right elbow. Come back to center. Take the knees out to the side. Child's pose. Third eye to the mat. Reach out to the palms of those hands. Slowly come up like you're drawing up into a cat pose. Lowering yourself all the way back down. Left ear to the mat. Palms face up next to the body. Rock the hips side to side. And come back underneath, doing that same thing again. Chin to the mat, dip up those legs, lift up, baby cobra. Make all of those adjustments. Relax the legs, press up, king cobra, look up, rest the head, squeeze the glutes, bend the elbows, slowly lower. Touch the nose to the mat, inhale, baby cobra. Exhale, relax, press into the palms, inhale, come up, king cobra. Knees go out to the side, child's pose. Third eye to the mat. If it feels good, walk your hands over to the left. Press into those palms, sending the hips towards the heels. Come back to center. Take those hands all the way over to the right, pressing away from the palms, sending the hips towards the heels here. Come back to center. Let's slide the body all the way forward. Once again, right ear onto the mat. Palms face up. Rock the hips side to side again if it feels good. Bend those knees. Just take the feet side to side. Bring the hands underneath those shoulders. We're going to press ourselves up as you do. Bring your right knee forward. We're going to take a lazy pigeon. So roll onto your right hip. You want to point that right toe away. And then you're going to square off the hips here and gently lower down over that right leg. Third eye comes to the mat or palm on top of palm, whatever feels good. You can press into the top of that left foot, bringing that left knee up onto the mat if that feels good. For a couple breaths and always relaxing it down on an exhalation. Walk the hands towards the body. Pause here for just a minute. And then let's come onto that right shin. You want to place your right heel on that muscle in between the legs. And then we're going to come up into a king pigeon. You can stay right here. Use your hands for balance. Or you can take, roll the shoulders back. Take the hands up off of the mat. Rest the head in between the shoulder blades. Finding a little bit of balance here. Gently release, coming forward. Take your right hand, lean into your right palm. Bend your left knee, take the left hand back, grabbing onto that left foot ankle, and then kick back here. Bring the left shoulder slightly forward as you do, kick a little deeper. Squeeze your left glute. And then gently release, coming forward. Fall onto your right hip. We're going to take full expression of pigeon. You're going to bring your right foot all the way up so it's in alignment with your knee. And then if you can, maybe lift up and then lower down, squaring off those hips, lowering down over that right leg. Once again, you can press into the top of that left foot if it feels good. Take deep breaths as you breathe into the belly. Feel it pressing in that inner thigh and open up that psoas on the outside of that right thigh. Relax that leg down on an exhalation. Let's slowly come up. Pause here for just a moment. And then lean over onto your right. Bring that right foot back. Let's take it back all the way. We're going to press into that right toe, that right ball of the foot. Drop your right hip. Maybe paint your mat once again with those toes. And then we're going to lower all the way down so you can feel that work. Take the right ear to the mat, palms face up, rock the hips side to side, and just feel all that length that you've created. The right leg should feel slightly longer than the left. Hands underneath the shoulders, gently press the body up, taking it to the other side, peeling yourself up off the mat. Bring the left knee forward, let me turn it. Left knee comes forward, fall into that left hip, point that left toe away, square off those hips, and lower down over that left leg.
Don't let nobody ever tell you that it shouldn't be so. Don't let nobody ever tell you that I'm the one.
Walk the hands towards the body,
coming
up. Pause here for just a moment, and then we'll come onto the top of that left shin, placing that left heel on the muscle in between the legs. Let's walk the hands towards the body for a king pigeon here. Use the hands here for balance. Roll those shoulders back if you want. Hands up off the mat. Head rest in between the shoulder blades, finding balance here. Gently come forward, hands on either side of that left knee, bend your right knee. Take your right hand back, grabbing onto that right ankle, kick. Bring the right shoulder forward, keep that right toe pointed to the sky. Squeeze your right glute. Gently release, coming forward, falling onto that left thigh. Bringing that left foot up, lining up the left knee and that left ankle. Square out those hips. And lower down over that left leg. Nice deep breaths is what opens up that psoas on the outside of that left leg. Slowly come up. Let's take that left leg back. Come forward. Press out through that left heel.
Every day is
drop the left hip. Feel that stretch. That feels good. Paint the mat with those toes, rolling it back and forth. Lowering yourself all the way down onto the mat. Left ear to the mat. Palms face up next to the body and relax.
But they found a home with you. Whoa.
That feels good. Bend those knees. Switch your wipers to the right, to the left.
Better with you. Life is better with you. Whoa, whoa.
Come to center. Take the knees out to the side. Hands underneath the shoulders. Press back. Child's pose. Third eye to the mat. If you want to take stone pose, you can bring those thighs together and then bring the palms face up next to the thighs, third eye to the mat. Allow the shoulders to melt out over the right and left side of those knees.
These days, life is better with you. Some days are better than other days, but these days, life is better with you.
Bring the palms next to the knees, press into the palms, slowly rise. We're going to take a tortoise pose here. Let's squeeze those thighs together. Inhale, bring the hands up. Exhale, hands down. Inhale, hands up. Exhale, hands down. Let's lean forward. Bring the palms back behind. Interlace the hands. Pull the body back up. Let's open up the chest. Roll the shoulders. Rest the head in between the shoulder blades.
Life is better with you.
Come back to center. Inhale, hands up. Bring the palms together. Cross the thumbs. Walk the biceps up the ears, lengthening the body. Belly button tight. Take a slight back bend. Exhale, hinges away. So belly button comes in. The nose comes as close to those knees as you can. Slide those pinky blades forward. It's an active pose. The head rests in between the shoulders on the mat. We're reaching forward as we squeeze the thighs together and press the hips towards the heels, reaching forward. Take a deep breath in, squeeze those thighs, engage the core, slowly rise, coming all the way up. Exhale, hands down. Inhale, hands up. Exhale, left hand finds the right knee. Right hand goes back. Roll the shoulder, look over your right shoulder, lengthening the spine. Inhaling back up. Exhale, right hand, left knee. Roll that left shoulder, look over the left shoulder, lengthen the spine. Inhale back up to center. Exhale, let's bring the hands down to the side. Let's come forward. We're going to come to sit on the sides of the mat, taking the legs out into a V shape. Bring your hands back behind you and press yourself up and forward into your edge. And then let's just flex the toes back and forth a couple of times here. Roll the ankles out. And roll the ankles in.
We could be the healing.
flex the toes towards the face. Bring the heel. You're squeezing the muscle to the bone enough in your legs that you bring those heels up off of the mat. We're going to inhale. Bring the hands up over the head. Nice deep breath in. On an exhale, relax the resistance in the legs as you slowly come forward. Hands out in front of you. And then just allow yourself to breathe yourself down. There's no need to force yourself down. Don't compare to anybody else. We all feed and eat ourselves differently. You can have the option of keeping the hands out in front of you, maybe taking them to the ankles, or bringing them back behind you, and then just allow yourself to breathe yourself down.
Wish I could tell them that nobody's gonna judge them, and every stranger on the block is gonna love them. No one in the world could ever hurt them, but I can't say that today. Oh, no one could ever take your pride from you. Speak your truth.
And then bring those hands to a comfortable position in front of you. Gently press the palms, slowly rising. Smile, it feels good. Bring that left foot to the inside of that right thigh. We're going to inhale it center. Twist the waist towards that right leg. One hand on either side of the right leg. Nose comes towards that knee. Maybe lift the hip and replant it. You can play with this stretch by flexing the toes towards the face, pressing the back of the leg into the mat, squeezing the muscle to the bone as you reach up with that right heel, and always relaxing it on an exhale, allowing yourself to go further forward. Check in with the position of your hands. The right hand is on the outside of the right foot or the right leg. Your left hand comes to the outside of that right foot or right leg as you lift your left shoulder, looking underneath your left armpit. So you're breathing deeply into that left upper rib cage and that left lower back. Again, we're not forcing ourselves into this stretch. We're breathing ourselves into it. Maybe take your right hand and lift your left shoulder to go a little bit deeper. Hands on the outside of that right leg or right foot. Left ear on that left bicep as you lean forward, lifting your right hip up and pressing it back.
It's like somebody dropping a pebble into a pond and sending ripples out to the world.
Bring the nose back towards the knee. Feel the stretch. Gently draw the hands up that right leg. Lean over to your left. Take your right leg back. Point that right toe away. And then let's just come forward here. Gently walk the hands all the way over to the left. Lean into your right shoulder. Gently pressing away from the palms, sending the hips towards the heels. Walk the hands back to center, taking them as far right as you can. Pressing away from the palms, leaning into that left shoulder, pressing the hips towards the heels.
We can be the flower and the gun.
Walk the hands back towards the body. Coming up straight, we'll bring the hands back behind us. Let's keep the fingertips pointing towards the knees. Roll those shoulders, opening up the chest here. Look up. Come back to center.
You got to
take it to the other side. Right foot comes into the inside of that left leg. We're going to inhale at the center. Twist at the waist with that left leg. One hand on either side of the left leg as you bring the nose towards the knee. Maybe lift the hip and replant it.
Every mountain that I climbed, every pitfall that I fell into. Remember me and you dancing in the living room. Cooking in the kitchen, bringing music to the barbecue. So many ups and downs, but we turn the frowns around.
Right hand finds the outside of that left foot. Lifting your right shoulder. So as we lift our shoulder, we're breathing into this right upper ribcage, right lower back. On the exhalation, relax your right hip and your right knee towards the floor. If you want to go a little bit deeper, you can take that left hand and lift that right shoulder up.
Enjoy every second you feel. You got to enjoy every second, cause life is short, so enjoy every second you feel.
Right ear, rest on that right bicep as you come to the inside of that left foot. Lifting the left hip off, pressing it back here for the stretch. Nose back towards that knee. Drawing the hand to that left leg, lean over to the right, take that left leg back, pointing that left toe away, and then gently coming forward here.
Traveling the nations and you bring me inspiration, boo, but life is never easy, but you make it all worth living through, like sitting on the beach with sandy feet and
walk the hands all the way over to the right, pressing away from the palms, sitting the hips towards the heels.
No, cause when it's gone, it's gone.
Walk the hands back to center, take the hands all the way over to the left, leaning to that right shoulder, pressing the hips back.
It's gone, it's gone away, so you got to enjoy it.
Walk the hands towards the body, this time point the toe or the fingers away from the feet, came up off those feet onto the fingertips, roll the shoulders, lifting the chest, looking up. Let's roll around onto our back. Let's take a happy baby. Grab onto your toes. Bring the knees into those underarms. And hold onto the toes here. Press the lower back into the mat. Dip the chin just slightly to further lengthen that spine. Grab, take the hands on the inside of the feet. Hold here. Take the hands to the outside of the feet. Knees into the chest. Circles to the left and the right.
You feel you got to enjoy every second.
For inversion,
so enjoy.
Take the legs up to the sky. Zombie the hand, dead bone. Just pause here. Feel that energy and the blood flow moving from the fingertips to the toes into the hands and the feet, the arms and the legs. And then when you're ready, release and make any movements here that you feel like your body needs before we come into that final resting space of Shavasana. Maybe take a little side twist.
Yay, there's your Michael Franti playlist, everybody. Good job. You ready to meditate? My favorite part of yoga. Let's find ourselves coming into Shavasana for complete and total relaxation. You want to lay down flat on your mat with the palms face up next to the body here and just kind of wiggle around until you find that spot that feels comfortable for you. If you tend to get cold after yoga like I do, throw a blanket over you or throw on a sweatshirt, whatever feels good. And then let's take three deep breaths. The reason why I do everything in threes, three is the magical number of creation. It takes a man and a woman to create a child. So this number of three is the number of creation. Take a deep breath in through the nose. Exhale out the mouth. Inhale through the nose. Exhale out the mouth. Inhale through the nose. Exhale out through the mouth. Scan the body from the top of the head to the bottoms of the feet and release any resistance fully and completely. Take a moment and feel gratitude for the physical body. Gratitude for what the body could and could not do today. Never comparing to another as we all come in at different levels. Relax the muscles of the face. Relax the muscles in the neck. The muscles in the shoulders. The left arm. The left hand. The left fingers. Relax the muscles in the right arm. The right hand. And the right fingers. Relax the center of the body. Feel the body melting to the left and to the right. Feel the muscles on the back of the body and the center of the body. Release. Feel how the body's connected to the earth here. Relax the left leg, the left foot, the left toes. Relax the right leg, the right foot, and the right toes. Take your awareness to where the pressure points are connected to the earth here. If you're sitting, feel where you're rooted. If you're lying down flat, feel those pressure points on the back of the head, the backs of the hands, the heels, the back of the legs, and the arms. And from these pressure points, once again, illuminate this dance floor. And remember, as I said at the beginning of class, with each footstep that we take on this planet, we are leaving our energetic footprint behind. And in this dance floor is energy of celebration, energy of unity, energy of self-authenticity. We only give the good energy and we only take the good energy. We only take the good energy and we only receive the good energy. Breathe. Scan the body, release fully and completely. And from these pressure points, from this lit up dance floor, start to feel like you're laying in a lake of white light. With each exhalation, visualize a ripple of energy moving away from the body, allowing us to share each other's energy, remembering that we all come from the same source. There is no greater than, there is no less than, there just is. All energy holding different vibrations, allowing for different experiences. And from these pressure points on your next deep breath in, breathe that white light up into the body. Visualize it coming in through those pressure points, filling the body up like a steam. Allow yourself to breathe it up into the outer layers of the skin. Feel that pause at the top of the breath where you're neither breathing in or breathing out. You just are. And then on the exhalation, melt that white light down through the body, feeling it melt layer by layer, sending it out through those pressure points and start to create roots below you like a tree. From the base of the spine, create a line of energy and visualize it going deep into the earth, going down around the earth's core, circling up that earth core energy, and then breathing it back up the line into those roots, into the body, lighting it up. As you breathe it into the outer layers of the skin, we're cleansing, purging, and purifying the body to the gene core cell level. And then feel it melting back through the body on the exhalation, layer by layer. Breathe. Without moving, feel the arms and the legs, the hands and the feet. Feel those lines dimming of where the physical body is connected to the earth, creating that levitation feeling, that lightness, but still feeling grounded by that line around the earth's core. And feel the body being pulled into the earth just by taking your awareness to that line. Look through the skins of the eyes and take notice of any colors fading in and out. Maybe seeing the energy shifting to the left or to the right, or maybe moving around like a kaleidoscope. And just like when we were children, we would take sparklers on the 4th of July and create full circles of light as we moved it around. Create that same visualization and feel it at the base of the big toes, circling around the base of the big toe. Feeling it going around that second toe, the third toe, the fourth toe, and the pinky toe. Take the white light round and round at the ankles. Take it round and round at the knees. Round and round at the top of the leg where the leg connects to the pelvic bone. Round and round at the waist. As you feel it spinning round and round in the waist, this is where we hold a lot of stress, anxiety, self-doubt, anger, and fear. And allow this white light to clear all of those feelings that do not serve us or our physical body. Allowing it to clear that away, and you can feel it. It's like you're moving a hula hoop around the waist. Take the white light round and round your heart as you feel your heartbeat. Visualize the white light entering your ventricle system, cleansing the blood and the veins from the inside out. Take it round and round at the shoulder. Feel it going over the top of the shoulder and underneath the armpit. Feel it going round and round at the elbows, round and round at the wrists. Feel it going round and round at the base of the thumb, the pointer finger, the ring finger, the middle finger, and the pinky finger. Feel it going round and round at the neck. Feel it going round and round at the third eye, located in the center of the forehead in between the eyebrows. And as it goes around, feel it passing the temples, the side of the head, the back of the head with each spin. And then feel that white light where everywhere we've touched, spinning all at the same time, at the toes, at the fingers, at the knees, at the elbows, at the wrists, at the ankles, the shoulders, where the leg connects at the hip, the throat, the third eye, the waist. Without moving, feel the arms and the legs, the hands and the feet as this energy moves through your body. Breathe. Feel the connection with that tingling sensation of the energy at the pads of the fingertips and in the fingernails. Feel it at the pads of the toes and the toenails. Feel it in the ball of the foot. Feel it in that muscle underneath the thumb and the muscle underneath the pinky. And then visualize as you take your awareness to the very center of the palm. Feel the center of the palm heating up, creating a line of white light and energy here, sending it out into the universe and into the earth. Feel a clear line of white light moving from the third eye through the forehead and out through that pressure point on the back of the skull into the earth. Take the awareness of the breath to the top of the nose and breathe into this line of white light. Visualize the pineal gland in the center of this energy, bathing and cleansing itself, allowing us more access to those parts of those to the parts of the brain that we do not use, and for more access as we look through our spiritual eye. Breathe. As you look through the skins of the eyes, see and feel the shape of your body lit up with the brightest of whitest lights, taking a deep breath in here, breathing it into the outer layers of the skin and beyond through the aura, feeling it on the exhalation layer by layer as it melts down through the body. As you send it out through those pressure points, into those roots, down that line around the earth's core, as you breathe it back up through the body once again. Take your awareness to the first chakra, located in between the legs at the base of the spine. Feel that warmth moving into the space, igniting the color red. Feel that tingling sensation on that muscle here. See the color red through the skins of the eyes, taking a deep breath in, breathing into the outer layers of the skin and beyond through the aura. As you feel it on the exhalation, layer by layer, as it melts down through the body, as you send it out through those pressure points, into those roots, down that line around the earth's core, as you breathe it back up through the body once again. Feel the energy moving in this space. Does it feel like it's moving to the left or to the right? Is it spinning to the left or the right, or is it just expanding out like your inhalation and collapsing back into itself like the exhalation, feeling that energy here in the first chakra? And remember that this is where we master our bodies. This is where we ground. This is where we find stability, security, and stillness, and where we hold the opportunities of courage and patience. Allow yourself the opportunity of courage, the courage to live your authentic life, to speak your truth, and to do it without the acceptance or permission of another. Allow yourself the opportunity of courage, the courage with releasing what you have been told life looks like, how life is supposed to be led. And leaving those stories behind, those old stories, and creating a clear slate for the new stories, for rewriting your own story. There is no right, there is no left, there just is. This is your life. Live it. You owe no explanation. And then allow yourself that opportunity of patience, patience with finding the courage to make these decisions, to switch up the energy in your life. You are responsible for your energetic flow. And remember, in that responsibility, you're also connected to all of consciousness. So whatever it is you do and whatever it is you say affects everything. Everything above, everything below. Breathe. And remind yourself as you move throughout your day that you're going to come across people who are on a different level of consciousness, a different level of awareness. So allow for that opportunity of patience to move through you and honor them at their level of learning. Breathe. Feel the complete and total stillness of the physical body here in this present moment without moving. Feel the arms and the legs, the hands and the feet. And then feel that energy starting to rise from that first chakra as it moves up the center, the core, the body, up the spine, and slowly rises up into the second chakra located just below the belly button, igniting the color orange. See the color orange through the skins of the eyes here, taking a deep breath in, breathing into the outer layers of the skin and beyond through the aura as you feel it on the exhalation layer by layer as it melts down through the body, as you send it out through those pressure points into those roots. Down that line around the earth's core as you breathe it back up through the body once again. Feel that clear line of orange light clearing the space, releasing blockages and dis-ease within the intestines and the internal organs. This is where we give and receive, where we hold our emotions, where we hold health, family, and tolerance. This is where we create and assimilate to new ideas and work harmoniously and creatively with others. Breathe. Feel the complete and total stillness of the physical body here in this present moment. Without moving, feel the arms and the legs, the hands and the feet. Feel that energy starting to rise at the center of the core of the body, up the spine, as it moves from that second chakra and moves up into the third chakra located at the sternum where the ribs come together, igniting the color yellow. See the color yellow through the skins of the eyes here, taking a deep breath in, breathing it into the outer layers of the skin and beyond through the aura, feeling it on the exhalation layer by layer as it melts down through the body. As you send it out through those pressure points, into those roots, down that line around the earth's core, as you breathe it back up through the body once again. Feel that clear line of energy moving through the space. If you've ever looked into the sun and looked away because of its brightness, bring that same brightness and intensity into this space, clearing it out. This is where we hold our will and our personal power. This is where we awaken and transform, where we hold our humor, our laughter, and our own immortality. And reminding yourself here, once again, that you are immortal. You are more than this physical body. You are more than this egoic personality that you've created. We are energy, and we are energy holding the vibration of a human experience. The floor below you is holding the vibration of a dance floor. These walls are holding the vibration of a building. We are all one. There is no separation. All energy holding different vibration, allowing for different experience. Breathe. Without moving, feel the arms and the legs, the hands and the feet. Feel the energy starting to rise up the center of the core of the body, of the spine. As it rises up into the chest, feel it on the underside of that chest plate as it pours into the heart center, igniting the color green. See the color green through the skins of the eyes here, taking a deep breath in, breathing into the outer layers of the skin and beyond through the aura, feeling it on the exhalation layer by layer as it melts down through the body. As you send it out through those pressure points, into those roots, down that line around the earth's core, as you breathe it back up through the body once again. Feel that energy in the bone of the chest plate opening up the heart to give and receive more love. Visualize the color green entering the ventricle system, cleansing the blood and the veins from the inside out. This is where we hold divine and unconditional love, forgiveness, compassion, and understanding. And we show these things to ourselves first before we can authentically share them with another. This is where we balance, hold group consciousness in our oneness with life.
Breathe.
Without moving, feel the arms of the legs, the hands of the feet, feel the tingling sensation on the pads of the toes and the pads of the fingertips, the white light in the center of the palm of the hand. And then feel that energy starting to rise from the heart center as it rises up into the throat center, igniting the color baby blue. See the color baby blue through the skins of the eyes here, taking a deep breath in, breathing it into the outer layers of the skin and beyond through the aura, feeling it on the exhalation layer by layer as it melts down through the body. As you send it out through those pressure points into those roots, down that line around the earth's core, as you breathe it back up through the body once again, feel that energy on the sides, the back of the neck, the front of the throat, clearing this space for a clear voice, for clear communication. This is where we speak our peace, our truth, our wisdom, and our knowledge. And we choose to do it with honesty, reliability, gentleness, and kindness at all times. In your awareness and knowing the effect that you have on all of consciousness, remember to speak with kind words. Now, more so than ever, your kind word is needed at all times. Kindness to the thoughts to yourself in your head, remembering that you are not those thoughts, just the workings of the mind. Your true voice comes from your intuition. Remember the ripple effect of your kind word. Your kind word may keep a person from harming themselves or harming another. Your kind word, even though a person has heard it repeatedly throughout their lifetime, maybe they didn't hear it or understand it until you spoke it. Choose kind words at all times. And in those moments where you're unable to speak a kind word, choose silence. Breathe. Feel the vibrations of the ohms from the music and the floor moving through the body, breathing it into the outer layers of the skin, feeling the energy rising up the center, the core of the body, up the spine as it rises up from the throat and enters the skull, feeling that tingling sensation on the underlying layers of the skin of the face as it rises up into the third eye, igniting the color indigo. Seeing the color indigo through the skins of the eyes here, taking a deep breath in, breathing into the outer layers of the skin and beyond through the aura, feeling it on the exhalation layer by layer, sending it out through those pressure points, into those roots, down that line around the earth's core. As you breathe it back up through the body once again, feel that clear line of indigo light from the third eye and out through the pressure point on the back of the head, once again visualizing the pineal gland bathing itself in this line of energy. This is where we hold our intuition, our spiritual intuition, our imagination. It's our imagination that creates our best life. It's our imagination that pushes consciousness further, that creates new worlds and new universes. Remember, intuition is held here. It's our true voice. Breathe. Feel the complete and total stillness of the physical body here in this present moment. Feel the breath at the top of the nose, breathing into the third eye, and breathe past the third eye and into the crown of the head, igniting the color violet. Seeing the color violet through the skins of the eyes here, taking a deep breath in, breathing it into the outer layers of the skin and beyond through the aura, feeling it on the exhalation layer by layer as it melts down through the body. As you send it out through those pressure points into those roots, down that line around the Earth's core as you breathe it back up through the body once again. Feel the energy here in this space. Feel it in the hair follicles at the top of the head. Visualize it spinning round and round like a halo above the skull. This is where we hold the unification of the higher self with our human personality, our oneness with the infinite, which we are, for there is no separation one from another. This is where we hold wisdom, devotion, selfless service, and our continuity of consciousness. Breathe. On the next OM, feel that energy at the crown of the head and move it through the body, moving into the violet, the indigo, the baby blue, the green, the yellow, the orange, and the red, moving down the legs and into the feet. Feel it moving in from the feet up the legs and igniting the color red, orange, yellow, green, baby blue, indigo, and violet out through the crown of the head. As you look through the skins of the eyes, see the energy and see the rainbow moving down the center of the body. The reason why we all connect with the rainbow in the sky is it already resides within our being. Another clear indication that we are all one, that we are all connected. Breathe. As you look through the skins of the eyes, see and feel the shape of the body lit up with the brightest of whitest lights. And then breathe on your inhalation, this physical, the spiritual visualization right out of the physical body. And on the exhalation, put the spiritual self separate from the physical body as the physical body melts into itself layer by layer, creating two. Send that energy out through those pressure points into those roots, down that line around the Earth's core. As you breathe it back up the line into the body, breathing into the outer layers of the skin and beyond through the aura, grab back onto your spiritual visualization, and on the exhalation, bring the two back to one. Breathe. 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 Feel the complete and total stillness of the physical body. Feel that energy moving through the physical body, knowing that you're cleansing, purging, and purifying the body to the gene core cell level. You're released those blockages of dis-ease, having created more awareness. Without moving, feel the arms and the legs, the hands and the feet. Feel the stillness of the physical body. And in your stillness, just start to bring yourself from a non-duality state into a more dual state. Starting to take in the temperature, noticing the warmth and the coolness. Maybe taking in the faint sound of the voices in the background. The sound of the heater. Maybe feeling the light moving through the skin and through the skins of the eyes. And then without using the mind to come back into a more aware and awakened state, feel the body and see how the body chooses to manifest itself back into a more aware and awakened state. That may look like wiggling the fingers and the toes, maybe moving into a stretch, maybe it's simply opening the eyes and allowing the body to wake up around the eyes. And then when you're ready, slowly coming onto your left or your right-hand side, bringing the knees into the chest and pausing in the fetal position and taking a moment showing gratitude and honoring this position, as this is the position we came into this lifetime in, and this is how we'll go forward, having cleansed, purged, and purified the body to the gene core cell level, having opened up different brain wavelengths, having changed our molecular structure. Take a moment, show gratitude to the physical body. Everything working in unison in order to have this human physical experience. The skeletal system, the skin, the liver, the lungs, the kidneys, the brain, the heart. Take a moment, show gratitude to all of those things outside of the physical body, known and unknown to us, working in unison in order to have this human physical experience. The sun, the moon, the stars, the space in between, and this earth. There is no separation. The earth is a living organism. We are a living organism. We are living organisms living on this earth. It is our home. It is our blessed responsibility to take care of it. And in taking care of our earth, we take care of ourselves. In taking care of ourselves, we take care of others. Once again, we are all connected. And then when you're ready, slowly coming up into a seated position, bringing your hands to your heart center. We're going to take a deep breath in through the nose and exhale out the mouth to seal off our practice. On all planes of consciousness, in any and all dimensions, in the north, south, east, west, above, below, and within, around everything that ever was, everything that is, and everything that will be, we cast the rings past not of air, of earth, of fire, of metal, of wood, of water, and of spirit. May that which comes to us, may that which comes from us, and may that which comes through us, may it always be the all's own pure love, truth, life, light, and wholeness. We are all one held in the infinite living mind of the all, and there is no separation one from another. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Namaste. Thank you, everybody.